What's up, Madeira? I'm Francis Baroni.
And I'm Andrew Philpott.
Welcome back to another great week's episode of What's Up, Madeira.
You know, Fran, spring break's coming up. Do you have any special plans?
Yeah, I'm actually going on a cruise with some of my friends.
Well, that sounds really dumb.
Really? What are you doing?
Actually, I'm going to Florida with the baseball team. But for those staying in Cincinnati, let's see what your weather will look like next week.
This is Jack Hanlon reporting live for the weather. We're out here, it's warm. As you can see, it's getting warmer. I'd recommend that you wear shorts every day and short sleeve shirts. As you can see, all the leaves grow back on the trees, so it's definitely getting warmer.
We don't have to worry about nothing.
It's pretty warm outside, so I recommend that you don't need to bundle up the whole week. Have a great spring break, everybody.
I'm so glad I'm going to be on a beach soon.
Yeah, that's going to be really nice.
Anyway, last episode, we aired the first ever lip sync battle. This week, let's check out round two.
For round two, our first contestant is Ian Marsh. Ian, what song will you be singing?
I'll be singing Amazing Grace.
Oh, wow, very religious.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm free.
Our third contestants of round two are Thomas Areta and Becca Bushhouse. What song will you guys be singing?
Breaking Free.
Okay.
We're soaring, flying. There's not a star in heaven that we can't reach.
If we're trying, so we're breaking free.
You know the world can see us in a way.
Due to absolutely horrendous performances by Ian, Tom, and Becca, they have been officially eliminated, and we go on to a tiebreaker round between Nick Tice and Francis Baroni. They will each sing one song, and after their songs, the winner will be declared. Francis, you will go first, and Francis, what song will you be singing?
Bodies.
Okay.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
Our final contestant of the tiebreaker round is Nick Tice. Nick, what song will you be singing?
Sir Duke by Stevie Wonder.
Well, that's a favorite right there.
Music is a world within itself, with a language we all understand. With an equal opportunity for all to sing, dance, and clap their hands. Well, just because the record has a groove, don't make it in the groove. But you can tell right away.
Wow, what a performance by Nick Tice right there.
I should have won, hands down. That's ridiculous.
Well, Fran, the judges didn't agree. But, Fran, have you watched much of the March Madness tournament so far?
You know, sometimes I watch it, but it's only so I can talk to the boys about it. But I really don't care.
Oh, well, In between the bells this week, we went around and asked Madeira to create their own bracket. Let's go check it out.
All right, we're here with Madeira's legend, self-made Will Thaw. Will, you'll be picking the first round games from the Midwest bracket. All right, Will, go ahead. You can pick your games. All right, there's the first round from Madeira's Midwest bracket. Thank you, Will. Now we have Henry Kahn. Henry, you'll pick the third round games. Henry, you take it away. Pick your four games and why.
I'm going to go with UK and just do the smart decision, as much as it pains me to say that UC is going to lose to UK. I'm definitely going to go with Maryland because nobody cares about Buffalo. Sorry, Buffalo. My heart's gonna go with Texas because I really do hate the Irish. And I'm gonna stick with the Jayhawks and keep them going.
Right, thank you, Henry. That looks like a pretty solid Sweet 16 right there.
All right,
we're here with Billy. Billy, you're gonna pick the Elite Eight games between Kentucky, Maryland, and Texas, Kansas. Oh, he's going with UK.
I'm a Texas boy.
And Texas, the Elite Eight. There we go. And finally, we have Thomas Areta. Thomas is going to pick the Final Four contender from the Midwest. Tommy, who do you pick?
Obviously, the Kentucky Wildcats.
There you have it. The Kentucky Wildcats seeking their ninth national championship. Now back to you guys in the studio.
So how's that bracket looking, Drew?
I don't want to talk about it, Fran. It's depressing right now.
All right, let's go have a word from our sponsor.
Rutrow.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Thanks.
State Farm, get insured today.
State Farm agents are there when you need them.
Ryan, with spring break around the corner, I heard you're going to meet up with psychology teacher Dan Brady.
I did. He had some really good tips last year, and I was curious to say what he had to say this year.
Well, Fran, I still use baby oil, so I don't know how his tips exactly worked out.
Well, let's go see what he had to say this year.
Due to some conflict with Mr. Brady...
I don't want him to be interviewed.
We were unable to interview him this year, but luckily we got Mr. Bolarski. Thanks for being here.
Oh, you're welcome. Mr. Brady is an academic legend who takes his teaching very, very seriously. I could understand why he wouldn't want to lose any instructional time to speak with you.
So, are you going on spring break this year?
Actually, I am, although it's not maybe your traditional destination. I'm going to go to North Carolina up in the mountains to visit my grandma. I want to visit her before she starts to get a little too old.
Last year, Mr. Brady gave us some advice on who to talk to in the club. Do you have any advice on how to dance in the club?
I don't really have that many dance moves that would be, you know, club appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
The running man, the cabbage patch, those are all very good. The water sprinkler is a good one.
Yeah.
And maybe do a little stanky leg,
okay,
if you've done the stanky leg before.
Do you have any tips for spring breakers who may be going into the ocean and may see some wild animals?
If you see sharks, make sure you check the weather forecast. You do not want a shark and a tornado to combine. I think that forms, shark... Like a shark hurricane, I think is what it's called.
Yeah.
So you want to check the weather forecast for that.
Do you have any tips for spring breakers who may be going to a warmer destination?
Ooh, lots of sunscreen. Lots of sunscreen, drink plenty of water, make sure you pack your swimsuit. I think Mr. Brady usually has his favorite swimsuit recommendation. I would, if you're a guy, suggest that you wear the longer board short variety. You know, no one wants the short shorts.
Of Speedos.
Yeah, I don't know about that. keep it classy. Keep it classy. Have lots of fun and be safe.
Thank you, Mr. Brolarski. Now back to you guys in the studio.
Wow, those are some really, really good tips.
Well, that wraps up this week's episode of What's Up Madeira. We'll see you in 2 weeks for the next great episode. But in the meantime, enjoy
Spring Break!
Did you just hit record?
It's fried. Okay, so I'm just gonna say.
Hey, friend, didn't. I got it. Ready?